Skype now is Dr. Murphy. He is a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Doctor, thanks for being with us.
Good morning.
Any of the numbers you're seeing out of China encouraging, or Italy? We saw a lot of deaths on Saturday, kind of went down a little bit on Sunday. Does any of this mean anything for us and how we're doing things here?
On the macro level, yes. Apparently things are coming under better control in China. Do I believe the exact numbers that they're giving out? No, I don't think any rational person does. But it definitely is moving in the right direction for them.
What about Italy?
Italy is really a disaster. And if we don't be careful here, the same thing is gonna happen here. It really is a crisis in Italy, and it's a model we don't want to follow.
I thought I saw that New Zealand was saying that if you got off a plane, you had to be in quarantine for 14 days. Do you think we should be doing that here? Do you think domestic air travel should be shut down?
I think either way would work. You either shut down domestic international travel completely, or you just quarantine people coming in from outside the United States for 14 days, like they're doing in New Zealand and Israel and several other places. As far as domestic travel is concerned, pretty much. There's not that many people really traveling, but I think it probably should be limited to essential business only.
All right, and the Defense Production Act, that's been in the news this weekend. I guess it's been invoked but not executed, and some say this is needed to get the supplies that the states need. What are your thoughts on that?
The supplies for
healthcare workers to manufacture more through the Defense Production Act, which has been invoked but not executed.
Yeah, they need to execute that. I don't know if you remember the story of Sewell Avery, the former head of Montgomery Ward's during World War II. I mean, he had to be carried out of his office in his chair by the police, by the military police. This needs to be done immediately. This is a war. We're in trouble. The market is not the right way to make this thing work, and it's totally fixable. To make millions and millions of masks is actually not that difficult, but they have to really, at this particular point, be ordered to do it.
Yeah. All right, here are some questions we got from viewers concerning delivered or takeout food from restaurants. We get this question a lot. Mm-hmm. Isn't there the possibility that if the person preparing it has the virus, that it could be transmitted on the food to you, and is there a simple fix like microwaving the food?
I think this is probably the most common question that I get. I think the whole food delivery thing is very safe. Nothing is 100%, but I've never heard of anybody getting coronavirus from a food delivery. Also, if you just cook the food, microwave it or warm it up, that will kill the virus. The virus is actually pretty fragile.
All right, next question. I am 62 and my 92-year-old father lives with me. I work at a popular big box warehouse and I'm exposed to thousands of people each week. Are we at extreme risk?
You're at risk, but I would say you're not at extreme risk. I think you're going to have to be pretty careful with your father, just his age, and he's probably fragile, and that be careful around him and practice as much social distancing as is possible. You know, nothing will be 100%, but do what you can.
All right, here's another question. It has been reported that COVID-19 spread in Wuhan from the first diagnosis at the end of December to no new cases reported March 18th, a 2.5-month span. Why is the U.S. reporting that this will last until August?
Okay, that's a good question, too. First of all, we think that COVID actually started in China in November. So it's really a 4-month period for them to get things under control. So it's a 4-month thing. Now, it depends of our intervention. If this lockdown, this shelter in place, if this works, all we have to do is shelter in place for 28 days, the whole thing will go away. I mean, it's that simple in some aspects.
Wow.
So please just do what the public health people are asking you to do. It will be the harder it is now, the easier it is later.
Right.
All right. If you have a question for Dr. Murphy, who joins us every morning at this time, you can go to our Morning News Facebook page. We'll post it there and we'll talk to him again tomorrow. Dr. Murphy, thanks again. Appreciate it.
Thanks a lot.
Hey, Paul.
Hi, you guys.